This is a Pelican 1650 military grade case. It was given to me, it was being done away with by a military unit because of this. It has a hole in it. The little foot, if you can see, there's 6 feet. Well, this foot broke off in some incident. And obviously you don't want a Pelican case with a hole in it. But I got it for free, and I am going to attempt to repair it. So here's the hole from the inside, and it's pretty clean from the inside. And what I've done is I've cut this thin piece of plastic. I scavenged some plastic out of another case, not a Pelican case. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to turn that down some though, but I'm going to make a patch, and I'm going to use regular old PVC glue. I've already tested this. I think I threw away my test piece, but I've tested this to make sure it will, PVC glue would work. And I'm going to make a patch. I'm going to make it oversized, and then I'm probably, depending on how well it adheres, I may rivet that patch. And then what I'm going to try is taking some of this stuff here, this Loctite epoxy plastic plastic bonder, and I'm going to turn it over, and I'm going to fill that hole from the outside, and then take another piece and patch the outside, and just see what that does. Now these are, I looked this up, this is the 1650 Pelican case. This thing is $284 right now on Amazon, and like I said, it was broken, they were getting rid of it. Why the military doesn't have a warranty on these things, I don't understand. But anyway, they were getting rid of it. And if nothing else, I was going to use it for the latches because I have a couple of small Pelican cases. But I think I can fix this thing good enough to use it. Good enough to, you know, for military use? Again, probably no. No, because that would be a weak point probably. But it's going to be good enough for me. So I'm real excited, real excited. Let's see if it works. All right, I couldn't show that and do it too, but I've glued the patch in, and now I'm taking these little sandbags. These are sandbags out of one of those weight vests. And then this is my sandbag out of my workout backpack. And using that to just kind of hold it down and mold it. Hopefully that's going to take. I may go ahead and do the rivets like I said, but either way, I'll give it some time, and then I'm going to do this epoxy and see what happens. Okay, I've let it dry for a little bit, and it seems like the PVC glue worked. That patch seems to be fairly well adhered. So for right now, I'm going to try to forego the rivets. And I'm going to flip this over and work from the outside and start putting the Loctite epoxy in. All right, so that seems like a pretty nice surface to work from. Let's get the epoxy and start filling this hole. All right, I've prepped the area with rubbing alcohol just to get any grease or dirt off, and now I'm going to just use disposable products to mix this stuff together. And I'm really wondering whether I should mix it here and put it in, or actually mix it there. I'm thinking about doing that. Why not? All right, that's not very attractive. All this stuff here is paper towel, where I was using 91% rubbing alcohol soaked paper towel to kind of clean up the area. Anyway, got it on there, and I'm going to let that dry, and may take a sander to it tomorrow, get it buffed down, sanded down, and then put another piece over that and see if that does the trick. May end up going with the rivets, don't know, but right now we're going to see what that does. All right, it's the next day, and I'm very happy with how that epoxy set up, but I understand that that's just a plug and there's nothing on this side keeping it from being knocked out, and on the other side is just a thin piece of plastic PVC glued in. So what I want to do is put a patch over this. I'm probably going to sand this some, but I want to build a patch. And I think PVC pipe is the way to go. So I'm going to use this piece, or maybe this piece. I'm going to use one of these little pieces to emulate this little foot over here. And it'll be going like that. And it will sit on a piece of flat PVC. I don't have any flat PVC, so I'm going to have to make some. This is just an old piece of PVC pipe from out of the yard. And what I'll do is I'll cut this and use a heat gun to slowly flatten it and make me a patch that can go from over here to this good piece of meat, over here to this good piece of meat. And maybe I'll even get kind of crazy and wrap it around. The problem with that is these ribs. If I do want to do that, I'm either going to have to notch out for these ribs, or I'm going to have to get rid of those ribs. And I would assume that those ribs are for strength. I would assume. I'm not a genius, but that's what I think they are. So I hate to get rid of them. So it would be interesting to have a patch that went, say, from here to here, and maybe a strap coming off the patch here. Get that flat, and then epoxy the new foot right there. And maybe I'll use this. And then I think we'd have a good patch for less than 10 bucks and a little bit of my time, which I actually am enjoying this. Well, bless me, Lord. Here I was about to cut up and melt some PVC to make a flat piece, and look what I ran across in my resource pile. It's PVC. It comes from back in my sign days. This was a piece of scrap that came off of a... this would be a sleeve that would go over a 4x4 post, but it's PVC. And I think it'll work perfectly. And I don't have to do all that melting and shaping and forming. Cool, cool, cool. Okay, I'm still working on the piece. Just a piece of PVC. And it's gonna fit like that. And I'm gonna use rivets. And then this is gonna be glued like that. And the idea is to mimic this missing leg. So just for fun, I thought I'd see how close to level it would be. So you can see that's, those 2 feet are pretty level. So I'll go over here to these, and you know what, it's gonna be darn close. It's gonna be darn close. All right, so we've got this pretty much where I want it to be. It's not pretty, but I'm not gonna spend the time to make it all pretty. Got it where I want it to be. And I've taken the 91% alcohol and cleaned the area real good. And what we're going to do is mix up some more of this epoxy that we used to make the plug. And then we're going to put this thing down. And once we get this put down and dried, we're going to glue this on here. And after all that's done, we're going to do rivets. So I made a little change. I'm gluing it on. The glue's not yet dried. I'm going ahead and riveting, or at least starting the rivets, because the glue's not going to cinch this down. So it's going to be glue and rivets at the same time. Seems to be working, though. All right, so I got rivets in. Pretty happy with that. Pretty happy with that. I know it looks like a Frankenstein's monster, but I knew it would. Most things I do have that appearance. But I feel like it can be solid, and... that's what I'm after. All right, I had a little bit more left of the epoxy, so I just kind of globbed it on, and I put this this foot on. If that foot doesn't work, I'm not real worried about it. The main thing I wanted to do was stop up the hole and reinforce the area. And I know it's ugly. I know it's an ugly mess. It reminds me of a story, and. My friend Poe, who every now and then watches my videos, will remember this. We were stationed in Kay Bay over in Hawaii, and we had a good friend named Ingram. And Ingram was a great guy, but he was a little intense. So it was probably a Saturday or a Sunday there at the barracks. And we went out off base and went to some model shop, some Japanese model shop. And if you know anything about it, the Japanese models are just really intricate and really detailed, and they can be very expensive. And he bought a model of, an M1 tank. Or maybe, no. It was a Israeli tank, Merkava tank. This thing was like, 1980 something dollars. It was like a $60 model. This is the kind of a model that would take a master model builder a week to build. So we come back to the barracks and everybody goes their separate ways that evening, or maybe the next day. I think it was that evening. We saw Ingram in the breezeway. He said, "Hey, got that model finished?" We're like, "You got the model finished? Got to see this." So we go back to his his building, and his model is finished, but it's just a mound of glue. And there's so much glue that I think maybe the main gun was drooping from the chemical heat of the glue. And I think Post says something like, "It's kind of rough, isn't it?" And Ingram says, "Yeah, but I'm going to sand it." And so so that's my excuse here. It's rough looking, but I'm going to sand it. So let's leave that to dry, and we'll check it tomorrow. And so I'm done. I decided to paint it a sand color, just because I think black is a very hot color. Put something over it so that this shine through. That's probably silly, but I wanted to. All right, so the inside is very smooth and it won't catch on anything. Most likely what's going to go in here is clothing, stuff like that, maybe stuff you would have in a backpack, stuff that I can have pre-packed, so I'm not worried about something catching on. But let's see how the patch went. There it is. It's ugly, but got another foot. And not only do I have that plug in there, but on top of it I have this PVC that is riveted and glued. And then I didn't sand this because I thought, why? I don't care. So I didn't even do as much as Ingram did when it was said and done. But anyway, that's it. That's a free $284 Pelican case that I've repaired, and I think it'll do just fine. I'm happy with it. Probably somebody could do a lot better job if they were going for aesthetics, and I hope somebody does. I'd like to see a video. I was very surprised there were no videos on how to fix a Pelican case like this, but maybe somebody with more skills will make one. Thanks for watching.